Hi, I'm Rehan Iqbal. I'm an IP validation engineer with Synopsys, and we're here at DevCon 2023, and we're excited to show off our Designware PCI Express 6.0 controller IP interoperating with Teledyne LaCroix's M616 analyzer. So here we have our Designware root complex IP put into an FPGA in our HAPS prototyping platform. On the other side, we've got our endpoint controller IP into this HAPS prototyping platform. Both of these are connected through cables carrying pipe signals to our two PHY cards. We've got our endpoint PHY card up here and our root complex PHY card down here. In between the two PHY cards is Teledyne LaCroix's Gen 6 interposer card. It's sending out the traffic over these cables into the M616 analyzer. We have embedded Linux running on our ARC CPU board, which is connected to the root complex. And I'll go ahead and run a script, which will configure the payload size. So here you can see that we've configured the payload to be 1024 bytes, aka 256 double words. So here you can see the captured traffic from the M616 analyzer. We're sending memory write TLPs from our endpoint to our root complex. We can see the upstream traffic indicated in the tool. And if I expand this link transaction, we can see the set of flits which make up this transaction. Can expand the TLP data to see the content of the different payloads. And I can see the response back from the root complex below. So it's interesting to note, in blue, we see the first double word of this particular link transaction. And I can see it took about 5 flits to make up this TLP payload, which again was 1024 bytes, AKA 256 double words. So we can see how this is spread out over multiple flits. So if I tag the flit record and select this option on the menu, I can actually view the flit contents within the tool. In the last 6 bytes, we can see the error correcting code, this ECC field. In the 8 bytes before that, we can see the CRC field. So this is used for the typical replay mechanism, and the ECC is a mechanism introduced in the 6.0 spec. And at the top, I can see the TLP contents. I can see our write address, the length of it, and the requester ID. So we have all this visibility in the tool, which is great. Thanks for watching.